Okay, welcome to the PHY4301 microprocessor and microcomputer for the first semester of 2021-2022. Okay, so I look at the registration list. There should be 20 of you. Okay, here. So I'm really happy, okay, this semester, because there are not so many students taking this course. Okay, so give me less headache to mark your test or final exam papers. All right. Because I also taught this course last semester. So the last semester, there are 37 students took this course. So they are almost double to this semester. Okay, so anyway, I hope you will enjoy the rest of the semester. Okay. Before we start, I'm going to show you the registration list to make sure that you are in the correct class. Okay, so these are the list of students that should be here. Okay, if your names, okay, if your name are not here, but if you want to register or if you wish to register, please let me know. Okay, so there are 20 students registered for this course. Okay, from the list, I can see that there are mix. How many of you are the final year students?
All of us.
All of you?
Yes.
Okay. So no one is third year and below, right? So all of you are fourth year students. Okay, and then from the list also. Okay, I look from the list and okay, so all of you are the Malaysian students, no international students here. Okay, so do you want me to mix between Malay and English?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so all right. I try to give the best, all right, to present in both Malay and English. So okay lah, you boleh maybe give you a better understanding, all right, to this course. Okay. Okay, so the microprocessor and microcomputer ni ialah berkenaan topik microprocessor, okay? So microprocessor is the what we call the mother of all computations that you need to do, okay, is within the microprocessor. So dalam komputer ada microprocessor. Okay? So apa you akan learn is macam mana this microprocessor or the microcomputer works. Okay, so this is the topic that you will learn in this course. Okay, so let's say from sending the information from a keyboard, okay, so you type dekat keyboard and so on. So macam mana this information sent to the microprocessor. So and then microprocessor akan process. Okay, so dia akan assign, akan give certain information to register to the memory, and then maybe you want to show that on the monitor, the output and so on. Okay, so itu yang akan belajar lah dalam this course. Okay, so let me introduce myself. Okay. So I believe many of you know me because I can also see my FYP students also here. Okay. Alright, so this is a little background about me. Okay. So after this, please create a WhatsApp group so I can share you the slides for today. And I also will put the slides on the Putra Blast after today's class. Okay, so you can add my number there. Okay, so we will meet every Tuesday and Thursday. Okay, so Tuesday it will be at 4 p.m. Okay, and for the Thursday one, it will be right now, okay, until 12 p.m. Okay, so sebabkan hari itu, sepatutnya kita start on the Tuesday, but Tuesday is a public holiday. Okay, dudu madu rasul. Okay, so later I will catch up with that. Okay, you guys tak ada kelas kan after Tuesday pukul 5 tu? Ada kelas tak? Hari Selasa selepas pukul 5.
Tak ada.
Tak ada. Okay, so maybe saya boleh ambil sikit lah masa to cover up lecture for those yang contoh kita ada public holiday and so on, so saya boleh cover balik dekat situ. Alright, so I will extend, so starting from next Tuesday maybe I will make a lecture a little bit longer. Okay, so maybe we can finish let's say after 5:30 or 5:40, something like that. Okay, so I hope it's fine with you. Okay, so it's compulsory for you to attend all lectures in order for you to get a good grades in this course. Okay, so okay, so let me honestly tell you that okay, so from the my last year assessment to the student, okay, so macam biasalah, the distribution usually follow the normal distribution. Kita tahu kan normal distribution, so ramai akan dapat A, ramai akan dapat B, C, D. Okay, so normally tak ada yang fail lah, as long as you submit all of the assignments and also you have a project. Okay, if you will have also a project letter. Okay, and then you can answer some of the quizzes and so on. Usually you will get D and above. Okay, last year, okay, yang dapat A daripada 37 orang dapat A, okay, and then the majority tu dapat B, alright, the majority dapat B and C plus, something like that. Okay, so memang dia follow the normal distribution lah, the bell curve tu, okay, bell graph. Okay, so I hope this semester okay, you boleh score lah. So I hope many of you will get A for this course. Alright, so this is about the course synopsis. Okay, so you akan baca about the architecture of the microcomputer and microprocessor. Okay, so you akan belajar lah macam mana that this microprocessor is linked to the memory, okay, and linked to the register, okay. And then most important that you will learn about the assembly language. Okay, this assembly language is a low level language. So you tahu kan beberapa programming language, dia ada C, C++, okay, Java. Alright, yang Java tu dah masuk ke high level language. So low level language ni yang mana kita gunakan the basic command, okay, untuk kita instruct the basic things. Okay, macam kita nak okay, kita terima input daripada keyboard. Okay, kita type. Let's say kita type certain words. Okay, let's say saya type Malaysia. Alright, I type Malaysia. And then macam mana dia nak proses M-A-L-A-Y-S-I-A tu, okay, kepada microprocessor. So microprocessor tu boleh tunjuk balik benda tu dekat monitor. Alright, so macam biasalah, so yang keyboard, apa yang you boleh send is just information is in the binary, okay, 0, 1 and 0, 1. So every character, okay, macam M tu, dia ada dia punya binary code dia. So maybe it is 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, so 2 to M. Kalau untuk A, maybe 0 1 0 1 1 0 1 1. For example, okay, that's for example, okay. So every character, okay, on your keyboard will have a specific, okay, specific binary code, okay. And then binary code ni, untuk memudahkan, okay, kita akan tengok dia dalam bentuk base 16, okay, or dalam base 10. Kalau base 10 tu macam biasalah, kalau base 10 macam 1023 sampai 10, okay. So we will learn further about that, okay. So but mostly in this course you akan learn about that language, okay, the assembly language, okay. And lastly, you will also need to carry out a mini project, okay, so that will be discussed later. Okay, so this is the learning outcome for this course. Okay, so what you need to achieve, okay, apa yang you kena capai, is the to relate basic computer and microprocessor design as well as combine basic skills in the assembly language. Okay, so this is the most important, okay. So because the assessment level is quite high, which is C5 and CTPS, okay. So yang ni you kena capai lah. Okay, so meaning that at least you are competent to do the assembly language by your own. Okay, and then you can compare the emulator techniques. So this emulator techniques ni, macam assembly language, you kena ada software, alright, or emulator lah untuk you perform that coding. Okay, so dia ada berbagai software lah, okay, yang you boleh pakai. And then usually I will choose the EMU8086, the emulator, okay, because that one is the simpler one for you to code, okay, the assembly language, okay. And then lastly, you need to construct the microprocessor program using the assembly language, okay. So ini berkenaan so ini akan ada satu, inilah akan ada satu quiz, okay, quiz berkenaan you need to program the assembly language. Let's say I give a certain instruction, okay, certain instruction, what you need to do, apa yang you nak kena buat. Contoh, you nak instruct, okay, let's say Ahmad nak pergi ke, alright, okay, Ahmad nak pergi ke kelas, okay. Tapi kelas mana yang dia nak pergi pada hari berkenaan? Contoh hari Isnin, dia nak pergi ke kelas PHY 4301, okay. On the Monday, dia akan pergi ke 4995, okay. And then pada hari Selasa pula, dia akan pergi again 4301. Okay, so macam mana you nak program that? Okay, so itu yang you kena buat lah, alright, for the microprocessor programming, okay, using the assembly language. Okay, so far ada sebarang soalan? Any question? Before I proceed further.
No.
Okay, tak ada soalan. Okay, kita teruskan. So this is the learning plan. So you will, okay, you will akan revise baliklah about the binary number, okay, yang mana you learn from the electronic subjects, okay, PHY 3601, okay. So you can learn first about the binary, because the binary is the fundamental, okay, fundamental of the number system, okay, dalam computer. So sebab tu you kena learn balik about the binary number, and then you will learn about the logic operation, okay, you know the AND, okay, AND or okay, NAND, so on, okay. And then later you will learn about the architecture of the microprocessor and microcomputer. Okay. And then between week 5, maybe it's between week 5 to week 7, so you will have the test one. Okay, and then after that, usually the assembly language is learned after the test one. Okay, but we will see how it goes later. Okay, and then we will see the how we, let's say you want to assess certain information from the hardware. Okay, let's say from the, let's say we want to send the information to the monitor. Okay, we want to change the color on the screen. Okay, we want to we want to input the we want to see on the monitor that the result will show after we press certain key on the keyboard. Okay, so itu apa yang akan belajar lah, alright, in this assembly programming, assembly language programming. Okay, so yang mana yang akan ada interrupt 21H, so you akan belajar what is the interrupt. Okay, interrupt, you ada interrupt 21H and interrupt 33H. Okay, and then later you will have the test 2, and then for the rest, okay, you akan maybe go through some of the how you want to design. Okay, how you want to design the program, the program that you want to make. Okay, so that's what you will learn, okay, in this course. Okay, and then ni textbook yang saya gunakan. Alright. Okay, so this is the hardcover one. For the soft cover, okay, yang mana yang saya gunakan lah, yang that I have. Okay, so this is the one that I'll be using, the main reference text, okay, from this book. Okay, so the 86, okay, so this one, the x86 PC, so assembly language design and interfacing by Mazidi. Alright. Okay. And berkenaan course assessment. Okay, so here is macam mana you akan di-assess. Okay. So you ada assignments. Okay. And also you ada assembly programming quiz. Okay, which is 10%. And mini project with the presentation. Okay. And you will have the test 1 and test 2, both of them giving you 15 marks each. Okay, and usual, and as usual, the final exam will contribute 40% of the marks. Okay, clear about this? Ada sebarang soalan?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Okay, so if you don't know, please ask. So human should learn better than the machine, right? So today we're going about to learn about the machine, which is the computer, which is the microprocessor, which is the mother of the computer, alright? So, alright. So shortly we will start with the first topic about the binary numbers. Okay. Let me change the slides. Okay, just before that, I think I want to give you a little bit about the computer history before we go to I introduce you about the binary numbers. Okay. So we look into the computer history. Okay, so pada zaman, alright, this is where the first computer is built. Okay. Memang sebesar-besar alam dia punya komputer tu. So, sebesar bangunan. Alright. So, dia tempatkan the bangunan komputer tu dekat satu bangunan, a warehouse. Okay. Yang mana cover 10,000, about 10,000 meter square. Okay. Dia punya keluasan tu 10,000 meter square. Okay. So, and then 250 tons. Okay. Yang mana berat that computer during that time. Okay. The transistor is designed, okay, to make that computer that time is 250 tons and houses more than 200,000 of vacuum tubes. Okay. So, computer yang mula-mula kita pakai the vacuum tubes. Kita belum pakai the transistor, okay, to make the computer chips. Okay. So, kita pakai the vacuum tubes. So, the vacuum tubes tu dia akan transfer. Okay. Dia akan transfer that akan transfer the information. Okay. Okay, you can tengok dalam in that warehouse, so you have multiple of racks and so on. So which place the actually this vacuum tubes inside of those racks. Okay, and then you have the second generation. Okay, second generation baru dia pakai transistor. Okay, but still at this time the transistor is quite big. Okay, so this started from 1956. Okay, so okay lah, dah dapat kecil kan. Alright, so you pakai just about half a room, so you ada satu bilik, so separuh daripada bilik tu is covered by the computer, but it's still big. Okay, still big. Okay, and the third generation, so you tahu about the IBM. Okay, IBM ni sebelum ni di ni lah, daripada jenama Lenovo. Okay, so Lenovo is actually come out from the IBM. Okay, so Lenovo yang take over the IBM. Okay, but the first computer was developed by the IBM. Okay, so tengok, so dia besar lebih kurang, dia makan lebih kurang 4 feet. Okay, 4 by 4 feet lah. Okay, dia punya besar, dia punya komputer tu take space, but it's still big. Okay, pada waktu tu memang komputer still betul-betul besar. So pada waktu ni dia dah menggunakan banyak-banyak transistor tu, so dia buat dalam satu bentuk integrated circuit, so dia panggil IC. Okay, so dia place the transistor, dia akan design macam mana you nak place the transistor and so on, so yang tu dia panggil the IC. Okay. Okay, and then we have the first microprocessor and microcontroller. Okay, so daripada development tu, okay, so you boleh kecilkan lagi, so you can make a tiny microprocessor. Okay, so yang mana you ada 4004 from Intel and 6800 from the Motorola. So you boleh design the transistor very kecil. Okay, very small, and then you can place that inside a very small space. Okay, so daripada situ you boleh compactkan. Okay, you boleh compactkan the design. Okay, so you can place so many transistors inside that. So sebab tu pentingnya teknologi nano. Okay, so makin kecil sekarang ni kita ke arah femto. Okay, so dulu micro, the nama microcomputer. So sebab tu nama dia micro. So dia gunakan teknologi sebesar micrometer. Okay, so you have the centimeter, millimeter. So you ada yang kecil is a micrometer. So 10 to minus 6. So dia punya size very very small. Okay, and then just now recently you have nano, and then just in the short term in the future, so you have the femto technology. Okay, femto, femto, and maybe moving forward up to the pico, pico, pico size. Okay, pico size transistor. Okay, so that is the advancement. Sebab tu you boleh dapatkan you punya micro, apa ni, smartphone besar ni sekarang. Okay, sebab tu, sebab dia boleh place the microprocessor dalam you punya smartphone ni, memang ada microprocessor, or we call that a micro controller. Okay, microprocessor or microcontroller. Okay, so dia boleh buat a very very small. Okay, so sebab tu teknologi tu penting. Alright, so you boleh buat very small, so dia tak makan space yang yang besar, but at the same time it can provide a very powerful computing power. Okay, so you boleh buat bermacam-macam task. Okay, pada waktu dahulu, okay, in the previous time, you punya walaupun besar, okay, you punya big, memang very big, that macam tadi, can you see that sebesar warehouse tu punya komputer, tapi computation dia cuma apa yang boleh buat, you boleh buat contohlah you nak kira macam you punya calculator sekarang, okay, so you tambah 3 plus 7, you dapat 10, so on, and then you boleh buat bahagi, you boleh buat darab and so on. Alright, so itu je dia punya capability daripada waktu tu lah. Okay, and then just showing, okay, daripada keyboard and then tunjuk ke monitor, itu beberapa function. Okay, macam sekarang you boleh buat, you can load up the, you can load up the software, you can browse the internet, you can, you boleh buka you punya browser dengan macam-macam tab, okay, berpuluh-puluh tab pun still, it still able to compute. Okay, so menunjukkan betapa pentingnya dia punya processing power, and at the same time you must do the mini actualization. Okay, you kena kecilkan dia punya size, so supaya dia tak makan space yang besar. Alright, so bila you tak makan space yang besar, of course maybe you can guna dua processor. Okay, macam server dia pakai Xeon processor. Okay, you boleh pakai dua processor teknologi. Okay, so you boleh pakai dua processor, and then maybe you can also do the parallel computing. Macam you ada too many data, okay, you have too many data come in. Okay, macam you log the information, let's say bila kita bercakap ni, okay, of course kita punya ni tak apa ni, kita punya call direcord tau daripada di telco, right? So you assume that, so of course every second tu memang mesti ada orang pakai handset. Okay, maybe dekat even ini je case dekat Malaysia, okay, every second, kalau you bandingkan dekat dunia, alright, so memang you boleh kira berapa banyak data yang perlu di store, okay, dekat telco tu. So so to store that much, you must have a very powerful computation server. Okay, so you also like the macam game, right? Mobile gaming, you must store the data, okay, from all of the users. As it right now, the technology is online gaming, okay, online gaming. So you must store, you mana you kena make sure that everyone is synced. So untuk process that thing, so you must first transfer from the data from the user to the server, dekat dia punya server, and then the server tu must be much powerful. So you bayangkan if there are thousand, multiple thousands, about 1 million of users using you punya game platform tu at the same time. Okay, so macam mana you nak proses kalau the your computing power is not so powerful? Okay, so if you look at the, ada satu movie tu, Free Guy, you, if you watch that movie, you see that ada dia punya developer tu, I pun tak ingat nama developer apa, dia memang satu bangunan tu memang dia tentang ada satu server room, and you look at the server room tu memang betul-betul banyak dia punya computer which is placed at the server room. So sebab untuk cater the capability of the processing, the graphic, okay, user interaction and so on, so many things need to be done. Okay, sebab tu you kena ada, if you want to build a very very apa ni, a top notch punya gaming platform, sebab gaming ni usually memang memerlukan very powerful graphics computation, so yang mana dia memang memerlukan processing power yang tinggi. Okay, so sebab tu you kena ada server yang betul-betul boleh capable untuk membuat computation. Okay, alright, so tu berkenaan the, okay, microprocessor. Back to the history, Okay, so this is what we have right now. So we have much, much more smaller and smaller microprocessor right now. So right now the microcontroller, okay, it can be like that, very small. So, but you can see still, it's still, we still retain the size, okay, like this one, okay, within that size, but you can place so many transistors inside that. Okay, so many, because the sense transistors can be made much smaller right now. Okay, so alright, so ini, this is important. Okay, so this is what you need to know. Okay, so you ada the CPU. Okay, CPU will do the computation. Okay, so you ada buses. So buses ni macam highway lah. Alright, so macam highway, dia laluan. Okay, between daripada CPU nak pergi ke RAM. Okay, buses ni dia akan ada banyak lane. Okay, maybe dia akan ada, boleh ada 4 lane, ada 8 lane. Alright, so itu dia panggil buses. Okay, so dia macam highway. So dia akan, dia boleh pergi ke sama ada is it going to be, let's say kalau you tengok dalam gambar ni, maybe you can pergi kepada kiri ataupun ke kanan. Okay, so the information that need to send, okay, dekat the microprocessor, maybe it's from the CPU pergi ke RAM, and then RAM patah balik ke CPU. Okay, and ROM pun sama. Okay, and input output port, okay, macam keyboard. Okay, you gunakan ni lah, input output port, timer and serial port. Serial port ni macam you guna last time for the your printer. Okay, your printer, apa lagi yang you gunakan last time yang pakai serial ni. So yang I remember is you pakai printer lah, but now printer dah pakai USB. Okay, even nowadays dah pakai wireless lah. Okay, still wireless, you still need to have the port. Okay, so which is you need to have the Wi-Fi port. Okay, Wi-Fi from the inside the computer, and then Wi-Fi that on the printer is connected. Okay, so itu berkenaan. Okay, so this is the general architecture of the microprocessor. Okay, untuk microcontroller pun lebih kurang sama lah dia punya ni. Okay, so microprocessor and microcontroller is almost the same architecture. Okay, except that microcontroller is usually having much less computation power. Okay, sebab dia akan handle much less task lah yang microcontroller yang boleh buat. Maksudnya ada certain function yang microcontroller boleh buat, tapi tak boleh ada certain function yang microprocessor boleh buat yang microcontroller tak boleh buat. Okay, maksudnya microcontroller ni anak kepada microprocessor. Okay, so dengan microprocessor you can do so many things, but when using the microcontroller you can do much less things. Okay, compared to the microprocessor, and in terms of price pun bezalah. So microprocessor yang mana akan menggunakan teknologi microprocessor usually much higher. Okay, mana dia punya cost lagi tinggi. Okay, you nak beli microprocessor lagi tinggi daripada you beli the microcontroller. Contoh macam you beli Arduino board, so Arduino tu pakai microcontroller. Okay, so sebab tu dia murah. Okay, kalau you nak beli PC sila mahal kan. Okay, and then contoh you nak beli apa lagi yang macam Arduino juga tu, Raspberry Pi dia pakai microprocessor, sebab tu dia mahal sikit daripada Arduino. Okay, so you ada microcontroller, you ada 8-bit, you ada 32-bit. Okay, yang mana 32-bit ni pakai ARM processor lah. Okay, so ARM processor ni dipakai dalam you punya mobile phone sekarang, if you know. Okay, the ARM processor. Okay, if you investigate, okay, you check kan you punya data sheet, you punya ni ada ARM processor tu. ARM processor digunakan untuk you punya mobile phone punya chipset. Okay, so kita ada 8-bit. Okay, so itulah jenis-jenis dia, ada AVR, PIC, CS8051. Okay, yang 2-bit microcontroller, ARM, via power PC, okay, PIC 32, okay, yang tu utilize the 32 bit micro controller. Okay, so ni dia punya internal architecture yang AVR tadi yang 8 bit microcontroller tu. Okay, so dia ada, okay, you ada RAM, interrupt unit, ports, okay, sama lah macam general architecture yang saya tunjuk tadi dekat apa tu yang sebelum ni tadi. Okay, this one, okay, dia sama je. So this is the basic architecture. So ni dia just expand lah, alright. Okay, so yang penting memang ada CPU, memang ada bus, memang ada memory, RAM ataupun ROM, okay, and ada timer, okay, and ada port. Okay, so itu yang basic. Okay, so ni sebagai contoh Arduino Mega, okay, 3 to 8. So dia ada pelbagai pin lah, yang mana untuk you gunakan untuk buat the terima input dan output. Okay, okay, so alright, so this one dia punya just different apa ni, list of the ni lah, different list of micro controller yang ada, okay, yang ada di pasaran. Okay, 8090 yang tu you pakai AVR punya teknologi, yang Mega tu 80 Mega, Arduino Mega, so on, that's the example lah. Okay, and then X Mega yang mana digunakan features like DMA, DAC, crypto technology, pakai X Mega sebab dia memang require untuk do the mining and so on, yang pakai so much computing power. Okay, so sebab tu dia gunakan lagi powerful microcontroller or microprocessor. Okay, so this is just another list of the ni lah, of the 80 processor, AVR microcontroller. So this is just the part numbers, okay. So dia ada ciri-ciri dia, dia ada berapa banyak dia punya capability of the ROM, okay, RAM dia berapa banyak, okay. So capability ni yang okay membuatkan apa ni, yang setinggi mana you punya apa capability untuk membuat computation. Alright. Okay, so ni untuk 80 mega. So you see that how different is that? Yang tadi macam 8090 tu, so yang tu pakai AVR technology. So dia punya ROM tadi ada 8 je kan, 8K. So yang ni dia boleh sampai ke 128K. So which is much a bigger ROM. Okay, and then timer pun jadi banyak lah, jadi 6. Tadi ada just 2 je. Okay, and RAM pun sampai 8K. Okay, tadi berapa hundred je. Okay, so ni dia punya architecture. Okay, so okay, macam dulu kan, ini macam dia punya chipset lah dalam motherboard tu. So dulu dia boleh pakai macam dia buat kaki, okay, sebelah, okay, dia punya input output dia buat sebelah-sebelah je. Now dia bertambah dia punya design tu, macam dia design, so dia boleh utilize the space, okay, sekeliling square tu, okay, so dia boleh utilize the space. Okay, so that's the technology in designing the IC lah. Okay, so ni TSSOP punya chip and SOIC punya chip lah. Okay, okay, ni chip yang Atmel CBGA. So yang mana yang this one pin dia kat bawah. Okay, yang tadi you tengok dia punya kaki dekat sebelah tepi, and then this one dia punya leg tu dekat bawah. So yang tu the function, yang usually yang this one is a microprocessor lah, yang kalau you pernah buka the motherboard, okay, you tarik dia punya microprocessor tu, dia punya kaki tu dekat bawah sebab you just chip, okay, kaki kat bawah, so you just slot in and then dia boleh function, okay, dengan when it has the contact, okay, between the slots and the leg tu, okay. Alright, so another more untuk 80 tiny, okay, and then this is just other example lah. Okay, ini just dia punya, just the properties of the ni lah, of the different type of the micro controller. Okay. Okay, so daripada nama tu you boleh tahulah dia punya apa, dia punya ni lah, dia punya manufacturer apa, okay, dia punya capability, dia punya flash tu maksudnya dia punya ROM. Okay, so flash dia ada 4K, yang 4K 80 mega dia up to 128K. Okay, so dia, tu dia punya ROM and ROM or RAM flash, okay, ROM, okay, ROM capability. Okay, okay, so if you are interested more, you can okay go to there. Okay, so to learn okay about all of this, the history of the computer, okay, starting with the our first computer up to today's technology. Okay, so that is our first topic for the day. Okay. Okay, let's have a 5 to 10 minutes break. Okay, and then we will continue after this. So ada sebarang soalan tak? So far.
Tak ada.
Tak ada. Okay, so let's go, let's have your coffee or whatsoever. So I'll come back within 10 minutes. So we start at around 10:05, okay?
Okay, Doctor.
Okay, so come back at 10:05. I will just leave this open.
I remember the day you wrote down the day that I fell for you. Now it's crossed out and weighed, but I still can't forget if I wanted to. And it drives me insane, think I'm hearing your name everywhere I go, but it's all in my head. It's just all in my head. But you won't see me break, call you up in 3 days, I'll send you a bouquet saying it's a mistake. Drink my troubles away, one more glass of champagne, and you know I'm the first to say that I'm not perfect, and you're the first to say you want the best thing. But now I know way to let you go, give my last hello, hope it's worth it, here's your perfect. My best was just fine, how I tried to be great for you. I'm flawed by design, and you love to remind me no matter what I do. You won't see me break, call you up in 3 days, I'll send you a bouquet saying it's a mistake. Drink my troubles away, one more glass of champagne, and you know I'm the first to say that I'm not perfect, and you're the first to say you want the best thing. But now I know a perfect way to let you go, give my last hello, hope it's worth it. I'm the first to say that I'm not perfect, and you're the first to say you want the best things. But now I know a perfect way to let you go, give my said what I wanted to. Maybe even cried for you. If I knew it would be the last time, I would have broke my heart in two, trying to save a part of you. Don't want to feel another touch, don't want to start another fire, don't want to know another kiss, no other name falling off my lips, don't want to give my heart away to another stranger, or let another day begin.
Okay, welcome back. Alright. Okay, so we'll start with the introduction to computing. So you will first learn about the binary numbers. Okay. So remember that please create the WhatsApp group so I can share this lecture notes with you. Okay. Alright, so these are the objectives. Okay, what you will learn is in this chapter. Okay, so basically you know that the binary numbers, you have the index base 2. Okay, so you need to convert that into base 10 or base 16. Okay, and then between those three. Okay, and then you will learn how to add and subtract the hex numbers. Okay, So hex is base 16. Okay, add binary numbers. Okay, represent any binary numbers in two's complements. Okay, represent an alphanumeric string in ASCII code. Okay, so ASCII code is this what you will learn. Okay, the ASCII is the number system that is used by the computer. Okay, so this is the and then after that you will learn about the logic operation. So I believe that you have learned about this before in the electronic subject. Okay, AND or NOT, XOR, NAND and NOR. Okay, and then use logic gates to diagram simple circuits. So all right, so these are the things that you should be able to describe, okay, once you finish learning with this chapter. Okay, so you know what is a bit, what is a nibble, and what is a byte, and what is a word. Okay, you can also distinguish between kilobyte, megabytes, gigabytes and terabytes. Okay, and this means the difference between RAM and ROM. Okay, describe the difference between the major components in the macro in the computer system. Okay, and then list three type of buses. So buses tadi saya dah cakap berkenaan highway. Alright, so highway ni ada tiga jenis lah dalam computer system. So we will learn after this. Okay, and then you kena describe also about the role in the CPU, and then list the major components in CPU and describe the purpose of each. Okay, so sebab apa, alright, kita gunakan 10-bit system. So sebab kita ada 10 fingers, so sebab tu kita pakai number 10. So kita pakai 9, pakai 8, tak pakai 12, tak pakai 11, alright. So senang nak kira kan, so 1, 2, 3 sampai 10. So kita ada 10 nombor, sebab tu kita punya nombor, okay, daripada sebab tu dia nak single digit number, okay, daripada 0, okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So patah balik and then they start 1, 0, 1, 10, 11 and so on. So they start dengan 0 sampai 9. 0 sampai 9 tu memang you akan increase. And so kalau base 10, dia akan increase lah. So ada 1 depan, 2 depan, 3 depan. Oh, sebab tu you punya number sekarang dia pakai base 10 system. Okay, sebab is originally based on the number of, sebab bisa kita kira. Kalau still kita start daripada kanak-kanak kan, kita mengira dengan menggunakan jari. Alright, so sebab tu kita gunakan dia base 10 system. Okay, so alright, so kita gunakan base 10 system. Okay, tapi komputer menggunakan base 2 system. Sebab apa kita komputer digunakan base 2 system? Okay, sebab apa dia tak gunakan base 10? Anyone want to answer me? Siapa yang boleh jawab? Okay, so ini jawapan dia. Alright, sebab kita boleh tengok voltage dia on ke off, on ke off. Alright, so kalau dia satu, on. Kalau tak, mungkin you switch on, apa, you switch you punya switch kat rumah tu. Okay, on off, on off. Bila you on lah hidup lah. Okay, off, off. So tak ada voltage. Okay, ada voltage, tak ada voltage. Ada voltage, tak ada voltage. Sebab tu dia boleh, komputer boleh gunakan that method untuk tentukan number system. Okay, sebab tu je cara untuk you buat the apa ni, you bagi tahu the computer untuk okay, you type this number, contoh A. Okay, you type dekat keyboard A. So hidup mati, hidup mati, 1010 1010. Okay, so ini menunjukkan dia punya code untuk untuk sesuatu karakter, okay, dalam komputer. Okay, alright, so the binary digit tu 0 and 1 kita usually refer that as bits. Okay, bits. Okay, 0 and 1 bits. So everyone clear so far about kenapa computer menggunakan binary based system, binary based number. Okay, sebab tu je cara, sebab kita nak on komputer memang kita kena kita gunakan elektrik. Okey, kita gunakan elektrik. Sebab tu bila okey. Cubalah kalau you ni kan cuba potong sikit wire you punya keyboard tu. Okey, you tengok function ke tak. Ini sebab dia tak boleh nak transfer lah voltage tu, dia on off on off. Kalau you punya wire tu even you punya wire macam you lipat, okay, dia actually the wire inside that akan jadi tak betul, alright, jadi tak betul, so dia akan affect the performance. When you type tu maybe dia akan tunjukkan different character and so on. Maybe you can try that if you want to damage your keyboard, okay. Alright, okay, to convert the binary to decimal to binary, okay, daripada 10 tadi kepada 2, okay, binary. So kita kena divide, okay, divide 2, okay, until the quotient is 0. Okay, quotient ni dia punya result lah, okay, remainder tu ya baki dia, okay. Contoh 25 bahagi 2, okay, 25 bahagi 2, you dapat 12 kan, you ada baki 1. So 12 tu is you punya quotient, okay. So then you divide lagi 2, divide 2, 12 bagi 2 dapat 6. Okay, sekarang baki is 0. Okay, okay, you divide lagi dapat 3, baki still 0. Divide lagi dengan 2 dapat 1. Okay, 2 kali 1 2. Okay, and then you ada remainder 1. Jadi baki 1. Okay, and then 1 bagi 2 you tak boleh lah sebab you kena letak 2 times 0, so dapat 0, and then remainder tinggal 1. Okay, so macam mana you baca dia? Okay, now you dah ada binary number dah. Okay, you baca from 1 1 0 0 1. Okay, base 2. Okay, so you dapat 25 tadi, 25 kan, so bagi 2 sampai habis. Okay, sampai you punya quotient sampai 0. Okay, and then you dapat the result. Okay, yang ni most significant bit ni sebelah kiri sekali, and then least significant bit sebelah kanan sekali. Okay, you baca start daripada most significant bit lah. Okay, 1 1 0 0 1. Okay, okay, 1 1 0 0 1. Okay, so daripada tadi daripada decimal kepada binary, now daripada binary nak ke decimal. Okay, so macam mana you nak buat? Okay, so tadi you kena buat, tadi you bahagi, alright, now you kena darab lah. Okay, so it's a reverse process. Okay, so katakan you ada 1 1 0 1 0. Okay, 1 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, so ini most significant, ini least significant. Okay, so macam tadi you kena susun macam ni juga. You kena ambil, tapi yang ni you kena ambil daripada sini lah. Okay, daripada least significant kepada sana. So you start 1 0 1 0 1 1. Okay, so yang ni is 2 to the power of 0. Okay, yang ni 2 to the power of 1 2 to 2 2 to 3 2 to 4 2 to 5. So you kena rap 2 to 0, okay, 1 kan, 2 to 1 2. Okay, 2 to 2 4 2 to 3 8, 2 to 4 16 2 to 5 32. Okay, so macam ni, alright. So you dapat, okay, so you dapat lah dia punya result. Only 1 0 4 0 16 32. Okay, so you sum up, okay, you sum up semua ni, okay, you akan dapat 53. Okay, so dia punya representation dalam binary is nombor 53. Okay, 53 ni nombor base 10 sama dengan 110101. Okay, clear so far? Sebarang soalan? So clear. Now, okay, so you dah belajar, okay, convert daripada binary to decimal and decimal to binary. Okay, okay, so ini just representation dalam ni lah. Sama juga kalau you punya konsep ni, you punya base 10 kan, you punya base 10 number, sebenarnya ni 10, nombor yang pertama ni 10 to the power of 0, 10 to the power of 1, 10 to the power of 2, 10 to 3, 10 to 4, 10 to 5. Okay, so macam ni lah dia punya ni. And then you sum up, you dapat balik nombor yang sama. Okay, itu dah dia punya konsep. Okay, so you know now how to convert from binary to decimal and decimal to binary. Okay, so ingat macam ni nak buat. So kalau you nak dapatkan decimal daripada binary, you kena darab. Kalau you nak dapatkan binary, you kena bahagi. Okay. Okay, sekarang knowing the weight of each bit in the binary map is simple to add them together to get the numbers decimal equivalent. Okay, so ini lagi cepatlah dia punya proses. Kalau you dah tahu kan? So setiap satu tu 2 to 0, 2 to 1, 2 to 2, 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 2 to 5, 2 to 6. Okay, so you tahu kan? Kalau you 2 to 1 tu 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. Okay, so you dah hafal macam tu. Okay, lagi senang lah. You just kalikan je terus. Tak payah you buat proses macam ni. Okay, kalau you nak, kalau you tak confident, you tak ingat, so you boleh buat proses macam ni. Alright, tapi you kena tahu kalau you dah tahu 2 to 5 ni berapa, 2 to 4 ni berapa. Okay, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. So you just letak je lah. Okay, ni kan 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. Okay, and then ni dia punya number, dia punya nama dalam binary. So you just darab 16, 8, 4, sorry, 16, 8. Okay, 4, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so you tambah semua dapat the result, okay, which is 25. Okay, 25 base 10 sama dengan 11001 in base 2. Okay, alright. Okay, so tadi okay, you belajar tadi kan? Okay, yang tu untuk multiplication. Yes?
Doctor, dengar doktor.
Boleh dengar?
Hello, hello.
Boleh. Tanya je.
Dengar
ke? Dengar. Tanya je. Awak nak tanya apa?
Tak tahu. Aku call internet saya lambat. Saya kurang faham sikit doktor. Pertama sekali yang kat bahagian yang belakang tu, slide sebelum, pertama tu kita korang faham sikit. Slide sebelum tu, sebelum lagi doktor. Yang tu. Yang dekat decimal, yang decimal sebelah ada binary tu. Macam ni kita determine doktor, eh? Contoh macam kalau decimal 1, binary 1. Decimal 0, binary 0, 0. Kalau decimal 4, binary 100. Itu kita determine macam ni tu.
Ini samalah. Okey, you tengok balik eh. Okey, you tengok balik. Ya, ini sama je dengan kat sini. You tengok yang ni. Okey, ini dekat kosong. So kosong ni dekat yang hujung sekali lah. Ini hujung sekali. So 1. Ini dia punya result 1. Okey, 1 2 kali kosong ni, 2, 1 ni yang nombor 2 ni, okey. Ini bagi ni kosong, okey, so kosong-kosong lah. Okey, sebab yang 4, 2 ni kosong, 2 kali 1 kosong, kosong. So yang ini 4 yang ketiga, yang ini kan 2, 2, okey. So dia 1 dekat sini, so 1, kosong, kosong. Okey, so sebab yang belakang ni is 2, 2, 0, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 yang ni. So yang maksudnya you tak kisahlah yang belakang-belakang ni. Yang penting is yang value yang dekat you multiply ni. Okay, so 2, 2, 3, tengok ini 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so ini 0 lah. Okay, so sebab tu dia 0. And then lagi increase 2, 2, 4. 2, 2, 4 memang kat sini kan. 2, 2, 4 ini 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 0. So yang lain semua tak ada you buat apa-apa. So yang ini je. Okay, 1, so 1 lah kat depan ni. So dia sum up balik. Okay, ini 2 to 5 kat sini lah, 2 to 5 kat sini. So 2 to 5, 2 to 4, 2 to 3, 2 to 2, 2 to 1, 2 to 0. So yang lain tu tak ada apa-apa, you just multiply dekat 2 to 5. Okay. So yang ni binary you tambahlah semua. Ini 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So you dapat balik ni. Okay.
Oh, faham doktor. Alright. Ni faham. Kalau yang sebelah tu, yang slide sebelah doktor.
Ni.
Slide seterusnya. Yang tu, jap. Nak sebab kalau macam awake tu, yang tu kita ambil macam dia punya kuasa lah kan. Kuasa, kalau yang macam digit tu, kita ambil yang digit yang dibagilah lah, yang binary kan. Kalau yang macam sum tu, macam mana kan?
Tambah sum, dia. You tambah lah semua ni, tambah. 16 tambah 8, 0 tambah 0 tambah 1, dapat 25.
Yang
ini dapat 16 ni, dapat 16 dapat 8 ni.
16 kosong tu macam tu.
Ini you multiply je lah dengan digit. Weight dengan digit ni you multiply. 16 dah 1 dapat 16.
Oh multiply. 1, 8,
4 dah kosong. Okay,
dah faham. Terima kasih Ustaz.
Okay. Alright. Yang lain ada soalan? Okay, if not, okay, kita continue. Okay, tadi kan, alright, tadi sama je macam konsep yang sebelum ni. Yang tadi untuk multiply. Now kita gunakan untuk division. Alright, now kita gunakan untuk division. So macam tadi, bila you dah ingat, okay, dia punya ni, yang ni up to 2 to 5 kan, 32. Ni 2 to 0, 2 to 1, 2 to 2, 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 2 to 5. Okay, so you nak convert, okay. You nak convert 39. Okay, 39 to binary. Okay. So, macam mana you nak tahu that yang mana ni is 39? Okay, yang mana you nak tahu macam mana you nak tahu that this is 39? So, yang ni tricky sikit, okay? Just pay attention. Okay. So, you kena fill in yang mana yang the largest number dulu. Okay. Yang kat sini ada 32 kan? Okay, 32. Okay, you ambil, you put 1 sebab yang row ni, you kena letak binary number 1 and 0 only. Okay. So you fill in 1. Okay, you dah ada 32. Okay. So 39 minus 32 ada berapa lagi? You ada 7 kan? So 7, nombor apa lagi yang you boleh fill in? Okay. 16 tak boleh. Kalau you fill in 16 satu, dah lebih dah. Okay. 8 pun tak boleh sebab dia dah lebih daripada 7. Okay. Yang the next largest, 4 lah. Alright. So 4 if tak 1, so you dapat 4. 32 plus 4 dah jadi 36. Okay, 36. So you ada lagi 33. Ada lagi 3 kan? You belum fill in. So yang 2 ni you letak 1. 4, 2. Okay, dah jadi 38. Okay, dah 1, 1, 39. Okay. So you sum up semua ni dapat 39. And then ni lah you punya result. Okay, yang kat tengah-tengah ni. 1 0 0 1 1 1 base 2. Okay, so 39 equals to 1 0 0 1 1 1. Okay, 1 0 0 1 1 1. Okay, clear? Ada soalan tak? Before I move to the next slide. So you guys know how to do this? Okay, tadi you gunakan division. Nah, sekarang ni you kena just you fill in je kat situ. Faham tak?
Setakat ni faham doktor.
Okay. Faham. Alright, good. Okay, now we move to a level further. Okay, kita tengok based on base 16. Okay, base 16 ni dia panggil hex. Okay, hexadecimal system. Okay. So inilah number yang you akan belajar banyak dalam this course. Okay. Sebab apa kita gunakan hex? Sebab kita boleh represent dia daripada number 0 sampai F. Okay. 0 sampai F. Okay. So dalam base hex base system, dia ada 16 digit. Okay. So 0 sampai 9. Okay. Lepas 9 tu, selepas 9, you kena pakai alphabet A sampai F. A sampai F. So maksudnya A ni represent 10, B represent 11, C 12, D 13, E 14, F 15. Okay. So ni dalam bentuk decimal lah, sampai 15, 0 sampai 15, so base 16. Okay, so dia ada 16 number kat sini. Okay, dalam binary representation, of course, daripada 0000 up to 1111. Okay, so ini dia punya equivalent. Okay, kalau hex ni F, okay, you punya binary is 1111. Okay, sama lah, 16 lah, sorry, 15. Okay, 2201 kan, 2201 2212. Okay, 2238 224. Sorry, 221 22, sorry, dia sampai 223. Okay, 220 221 222 223. Okay, you ada 8 4 2 1. Okay, 8 4 2 1. So 8 tambah 4 12, tambah 2 lagi 14, tambah 1 15. Okay, so 1111 ni sama dengan 15. Okay, so bila dalam hex ni, so you punya representation of binary dalam bentuk 4 digit ni lah. Okay, dia dalam bentuk 4 bit. Okay, ni dia panggil 4-bit system. Okay, 4-bit system. So sebab apa kita gunakan hex? Sebab kita ada, okay, so 4-bit. Okay, usually kita ada 4-bit, kita boleh present dalam bentuk 4 nombor juga. 4, 4, 4, 4. So 4-bit, 4-bit 8, 4-bit, 4-bit 16. Okay, so kita ada 16-bit system. Okay, kita boleh tambah satu lagi kawasan dekat sini, so kita ada 16 16. So sebab tu kita ada up to 32-bit system. Okay, so, so tu system yang ada. Sebelum sekarang ni kan teknologi sampai 64-bit. Haa, you perasan tak? Kalau sebelum ni 32. Okay, 32 dia ada hex ni ada 4 baris, so 4 4. So macam ni lah, let me write. Okay, macam hex kan, saya buat list F F F F. Okay, F F F F. Okay, so ni berapa bit punya sistem? So yang ini dah jadi, ini 8 bit, 8 bit. Okay, tambah lagi satu jadi 16 bit. Okay, okay, so 8 bit, yang ni, yang ni 8 bit, yang ni 8 bit. So 16 bit. Okay, 16 bit. Okay, jap. Okay, yang ni tadi binary, you ada 4 bit. Okay, sorry, yang ni 4 bit. Okay, yang ni satu ni 4 bit. Okay, sorry, silap. Okay, saya satu ni, F ni represent 4 bit. Okay, 4 bit tambah 4 bit tambah 4 bit tambah 4 bit. So, you dah ada 16 bit. Okay, satu ni row 16 bit. Okay, yang ni pun ada 16 bit. So, total semua you is 32 bit system. Okay, so still yang ni digunakan meluas lah, 32 bit system. Okay, yang you ada lagi sampai sekarang 64 bit. Okay, 64 bit. So kita tambah lagi kat sini, F F F F. So F F F F. Okay, so dia ada 1 2 3 4. So ada, you ada 3, ada 4 F F F ni. So you jadi 64-bit system. So sebab tu kita gunakan base 16. Okay, sebab tu you ada, asal-asalnya you ada start dengan 8-bit, okay, 8-bit system. Okay, and then you increase jadi, so orang gunakan hex tu, yeah, jadi 16-bit system. Okay, 16-bit, and then upgrade to 32-bit system. And then upgrade to 64-bit system. So sebab tu dia punya increment tu macam tu. Sebab dia gunakan base 16 punya representation. Okay, alright. So, so I erase this one. Okay. Alright. Okay, sebab apa kita susah kan kita nak baca kalau nak pakai binary 01001 tu is a very long, a very long string. Okay. So 100100101110. Okay, so that is too terlalu panjang lah. Okay. So macam mana kita nak present that? Okay, nak present that small in terms of more compact number. So sebab tu kita pakai base 16. Okay. So kita pakai base 16. Okay, so number dia jadi 896. Okay. H ni represents the hex. Okay. Yang ni is hex. So biasanya kita letak H lah dekat belakang untuk present yang this number is 16 bit number. Sebab apa? Sebab apa kita tak H? Okay. Sebab 896 juga dipakai oleh decimal system. Okay, kalau kita letak 896, orang mungkin boleh assume that this is the decimal number. Okay, not the hex number. Sebab tu kita letak H dekat belakang untuk represent this is the hex number yang ini. Okay. 896 ni. Bukan 896 yang ni. Okay. Sebab tu kita letak H dekat belakang. Okay. 896. Okay. So you tengoklah balik. Sama ke yang dengan string ni. Okay. 896. Ini. Okay. You bagi. Ini 4 kan. 4. Ini 4. Yang ni 4. Okay. 100 ni 8 kan. Okay. 100. Okay. 8. 10019. Okay, 10019 and 0110 is 6. Betul kan? Okay, 0110 is 6. So, you dah represent, okay? Hex tu, binary tu hex number. Okay, clear so far?
Yes.
Yeah, doctor.
Okay, good. Okay, now we look at the example. Okay. So macam saya beritahu tadi, so kita kena macam mana kita nak present dalam bentuk hex. Okay. So first kita kena tengok dia punya pembahagian 4-4. Okay, yang ni 4. Kita ambil yang ini 4. Okay, yang ni 4. Okay. So yang ni nombor apa ni? Okay. Yang ni you tengok balik 2-2-0, 2-2-1, 2-2-2. Okay. Yang you ada 2-2-2 kan? 4 kan? 4 tambah 1, 5. Okay, yang ni 5. Right? Yang ni 1-1-1 ni F lah. It's very easy. Kalau 1-1-1 ni tengok 1-1, memang F lah. Sebab yang ni kan 2-2-0, 2-2-1, 2-2-2, 2-2-3. So, 2-2-3, 2-2-2, 2-2-1, 2-2-0. So, 8 tambah 4. Tambah 2, tambah 1. So, dapat 15. So, 15 tu dah hex is F. Okay? So, dia letak F. Okay, and then you dapat, again, one more is 1001. Okay, yang ni, 1 ni is 220. And then this one, 223. Okay? 8 tambah 1. So, 9. Okay, so you guys know how to get this? Okay? So, dia punya representation is 9F5. X. Okay, 9F5X. Okay, 9F5H. Okay, so do dia punya answer. Okay, anyone, siapa yang confused? Siapa yang tak boleh buat? You can ask now. Okay, so you guys okay? Alright. Sekarang kita nak convert balik. Okay, tadi kita dah buat daripada hex to binary. And then now binary to hex. Tadi binary kepada hex. Now hex to binary. Okay. So hex kita ada 29B. Okay. So 2. So 0010. Okay. So dekat 221 lah. Okay. 9. Kita kena ada, so kita ingat kita punya digit tu sentiasa ada 8421. Okay, 8421. So 9. So 9. So dekat 223 dengan 220. So dapat 9. B ni berapa? So B ni you nak ingat, you kena tengok lepas 9 kan, 9 A tu 10, B tu 11. Alright? So 11, you dapat 11 dekat you punya binary macam mana? Okay? So 8 kena tambah dengan 2, kena tambah dengan 1. So you dapat 11. Okay? So sebab tu dekat sini 2 to 3, 2 to 1, 2 to 0. So you dapat B. Okay? So this is your result in binary. Okay? So biasanya dekat depan ni kita tak ambil lah 0, 0. Sebab tu kita letak starting from 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay? You have 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay? 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay? Base 2. Okay. So far, okay?
Okay, Doctor.
Alright, good. Okay, so macam mana pula if you want to convert, okay, tadi kita dah deal with okay, hex binary, binary hex. Okay, tadi yang sebelum tu binary decimal, decimal binary. Okay, kita dah cover that. And then, now involve ketiga-tiga. Now kita nak involve hex kepada decimal pula. Okay, hex to decimal. Okay, so daripada hex ni, alright, daripada hex, kita boleh convert first kepada, okay, first kepada binary. Okay, sebab kita nak convert decimal, kita kena tengok first kepada binary. Sebab kita tak boleh nak convert terus. Okay, so which is difficult to do. Okay. So kita tengok pada binary dulu, and then binary barulah kita convert balik kepada decimal. Okay. So daripada hex ni, okay, kita dapatkan balik dia punya binary representation. So kita nak dapatkan 6. So kita ada 4 dengan 2 kan. So dapat 6. Okay. And then B tadi 11. Kita dapat 821. Okay. 821. And then 2 kita dapatkan 2 lah. Okay, kat sini. Okay. So, untuk jadikan daripada, okay, binary ni kepada decimal, macam tadi, dia punya proses is kita kena multiply setiap digit tu kan. Okay. So, kita ingat tadi, this one 220, 221. Okay, yang ni 221 ada. Okay. 223, sorry. 220, 221. 221, 222, 223. Okay. 224, 225, 226, 227, okay, 228, 229, 2210, 2211. Okay, so dia ada sampai 2211. Okay, tapi 0 ni kita tak kisahlah sebab dia paling depan sekali, so kita tak kira. Okay, so yang kita ada, so kita kena listkan lah. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. 9, 10, 11. So up to 2 to 10. Okay. From 2 to 0, 2 to 10. Okay. Yang ni 2 to 0. 2 to 0, 1 kan. Okay. 2 to 1, 2. 2 to 2, 4. 2 to 3, 8. 2 to 4, 16. 2 to 5, 32. 2 to 6, 64. 2 to 7, 128. 2 to 8, 256. 229, 512. 2210, 1024. Okay, semua tahu kan macam mana nak dapat ni value ni, this above. Okay, so you buat, just you buat kuasa berapa lah, 2 kuasa 10. Okay, 2 darat 2 darat 2 darat 2. Okay, so you dapat lah 1024. Okay, you, then you just fill in lah. Okay, yang mana ada satu ni just fill in. Okay, you start from here. Start from 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, okay. 0, 1, 1, okay. And then you sum up lah yang mana ada 1 ni, alright. So yang mana ada 0 dapat result 0. Yang mana ada 1, you kena sum up, okay. 1, 0, 2, 4, plus 5, 1, 2, okay. Plus 1, 28, plus 32, plus 16, plus 2, okay. So you sum up all of that, you akan dapat result dalam decimal, okay. So 6B2 ni dalam hex sama dengan 1714 in decimal. Okay? Alright. So tu cara you nak convert daripada hex to decimal. Okay. Alright, so you have that. Okay, so ini another example lah. So you can look, so ini lagi panjang lah. Tadi yang tadi ada tiga je, tiga digit. Okay, tiga digit of the hex. Ini ada empat digit. Okay, so number lagi increase lah. Okay, you tengok dekat sini. So ditambah lagi yang empat digit ni. Okay, tadi you ada, sorry, yang sepatutnya tadi you ada sampai sini. Okay, di sini, sini and then sini. Okay, empat ni. Tapi tadi di depan you buangkan zero. Sepatutnya 2048 kalau you ada number. Itu you ada number F lah kan. So you ada number F, so you ada 1 kat depan. Okay. So it's 2048 untuk 2 to 11. Okay, yang ni 2 to 12, 2 to 13, 2 to 14, 2 to 15. Okay. Sekarang you ada 2 to 15. Okay, so you nak tahu dia punya decimal representation. So sama juga macam proses yang atas tadi. So you just tambah, sorry, you just tambah yang mana yang ada 1 lah. Okay. So yang this one, that one, this one and so on. Okay. So you tambah semua and then you dapat this result. Okay. 9F2D hex. Okay, you dapat 40749 in decimal. Okay. Alright. So I think you can do that. Okay. So tadi the hex tu decimal. Okay. Macam mana pula daripada decimal kepada hex? Okay. The decimal kepada hex. Okay. Convert to binary first, then convert to hex. Okay. Sama juga macam proses tadi, kita kena melalui binary. Okay. Kita kena melalui the binary. Yang tadi kan, okay, 45 you nak convert ke binary, you kena buat, you kena bahagi kan. Okay. Ataupun satu lagi cara, you buat macam ni. You fill in. Okay, you fill in. So 45 ni, yang paling tinggi, kalau sebab after this 32, 64 kan. So 64 is higher than 45. So yang paling tinggi you boleh fill in is 32. 2 to 5. Okay. 32. Ni lagi 45 tolak 32. Berapa lagi remaining? Okay. Ada 13. 13, so 16 tak boleh. So 8. So 13 tolak 8. Tinggal berapa lagi? 5. Okay, 5. So 4 dengan 1 lah. Okay. So the binary representation of 45 ni is 101101. Okay, itu dalam bentuk binary. Okay, so binary ni 101101 ni sama dengan 45. Okay, and then 101101 you nak convert ke hex macam mana? Okay, macam biasa you kena pecahkan 4 4. Okay, yang ni 4, maksudnya yang depan ni 0 lah. Okay. So, kita tengok 4 digit ni. Okay. 1101. Okay, 1101 ni berapa? Okay. 841. So, 13. So, 13 dalam bentuk hex apa dia? Okay. 13 is D kan? A 10, B 11, C 12, D 13. Okay, so dia dapat 13. Okay, kat sini. So, D. Okay, yang ini 0, 1. Okay. 0, 1. Ni yang ni 2 lah. Okay. 2 to 0, 2 to 1. So 2. So 2, 2 lah dalam hex. Okay. So you dapat 45 decimal dalam bentuk hex is 2D. Okay. Okay, look at another example. Okay. 629 decimal pada hex. Okay, first convert to binary. Okay, so paling tinggi 512. Okay, sebab after that 1024. 1024 dah lebih dah daripada 629, so you tak boleh. So yang paling tinggi pun 512. Okay, 512 ni berapa? Ini 225, 226, 227, 228, 229. Okay, 229. Okay, 229. Alright, So you fill in 512. So 6 to 9 minus 512, berapa lagi remaining? Okay. So you ada you ada 7. You ada 1. You ada 117. Okay, so yang paling tinggi next is 64 lah. Okay, sebab 1 to 8 dah lebih daripada 117. Okay. So you minus dengan 64 lagi. So you masuk 64 ni. So yang tinggal is 53. Okay, 53. Okay, 32. Okay, 1. Okay, you tolak 32. So you tolak that. Okay, you tolak 32. And then you dapat 21. Okay, 21 you pay in dengan 16, tinggal 5. Okay, so 4, 1, 1. Okay, 4, 1, 5. Okay, so you ada, ni you punya binary. Okay, 100110101. Okay, so you ada this one. Okay, and then up to that one. Okay, okay, so, so sekarang you ada 3 digit hex. Okay, so yang ni 415. Okay, yang ni, yang ni 2, yang ni 421. 4, 5, 6, 7. So ini 7. Okay, yang ini 2. So 275 in terms of hex. Okay. So far, so good. Okay, yang bawah tu you tengoklah, you try buat. Okay, so it's the same process. Okay, alright, so we will continue, okay, next week, okay, a little bit more about the this number system, okay, so, but today you have what we have learned, so I recap what is the key takeaway for today, okay, so the key takeaways for today is you have learned about how to, what is the history of computer, okay, so you learn about how the evolution of the computer from the very big computers to the tiny computers, okay. That's the first thing, and then the second thing you learn about the number system. Okay, number system where you already learn how to convert between three number system, base 2 to 10, 10 to 16. Okay, hex, decimal, and binary. Okay, so you already deal with three of those. Okay, so. Sebelum kita stop, ada sebarang soalan?
Tak ada.
Tak ada, Doktor.
Tak ada, Doktor.
No.
Okay. Alright, so let's take a picture with all of you for today's session. Okay, so you could please turn on your camera. I'm going to wait for a few more seconds, right? You guys ready? Okay. Alright, I'm going to count from 10. Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Alright, cheers everyone. Okay, thank you for today. Alright, so I see you again next week. Remember, create the WhatsApp group for this course. Okay, I will share you the lecture notes. Okay, later after that. Okay,
thank you.
Have a good day. All right, enjoy the rest of the week. Okay,
thank you, Doktor.
Thank you, Doktor.
Thank you, Doktor.
Thank you, Doktor.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you, Doktor.
Okay, welcome.
Bye-bye, Doktor. Thank you, Doktor.